Hey beautiful souls, it's Ash, and today I am cleaning, organizing, and decluttering so many toys. If you enjoy turning cluttered chaos into maximum order, then I hope that you will stick around and hang out with me today, and let's jump right into it. So the first thing that I do is get this teepee fabric in the wash. It is full of cat hair and greasy fingerprints, as it should be. And then I'm going to start with my daughter's room. She's going to be 2 years old this month. I can't believe it. But my game plan is to take everything out of her room and bring it into the living room where I can sort it and organize it. I just like to have everything in one place so that I can really get a good idea of what I'm working with. Also, I want to make a quick announcement that my channel name is going to be changing to The Homemaking Mama. I feel like this name better represents my channel and my dreams for the future. So keep an eye out for that. And thank you so much for hanging out with me and keeping me company today. Put your arms around me, put your faith in me, put your love on me. What you need from me, need your love on me, put your love on me. So the thing with kids' toys is everything has 500 pieces, right? And the pieces don't just end up scattered all over the floor. They end up under the washer and dryer and refrigerator. I literally found a Barbie in my underwear drawer the other day. But what a difference when the toys are organized and rotated. I find it so much easier to maintain and actually enjoyable.
From your hands and your body, it hurts so much to think of you as someone else. Can't get enough when you're sweet talking to me. Now I'm talking sweet all by myself. Put your arms around me, put your faith in me, put your love on me. What you need from me, need your love on me, put your love on me.
So right now I'm just working on the closet, getting all of the toys out of there so that I can sort and organize them. And I ended up rearranging this room a little bit. So you'll see that coming up. I actually love how it turned out. But in the process of moving some of the furniture out, I found, honestly, God only knows what on the wall. It was super sticky and it was kind of difficult to get off, but I did manage to get it off, thankfully. And next I'm going to vacuum this entire space, get the floor nice and clean, and we'll come back to this room a little later. I have some finishing touches to add and it turns out super cute. Like I said, I'm excited for you guys to see it. But I'm going to move on to the living room and just getting the rest of the toys out there, organized, sorted, decluttered, and ready to be put back into storage. This is all stuff from my daughter's bedroom. I'm just going through and sorting it all. A lot of baby doll stuff here and accessories, that kind of thing. I don't have good storage for that, but I had mentioned that her birthday is coming up this month. We ended up getting her the Melissa and Doug Baby Care Center. And so it has like a changing table, a crib, a high chair, a little laundry area, and there's some shelves, so I'm hoping that we can store a lot of those baby accessories in there once we set that up. But I'm moving on to getting the rest of the toys that are out of rotation and sorting through them so I can get them all into categories. And then we're gonna get onto the fun part, which is organizing it all. Keep on driving and driving along the road tonight. As my head will fill my spark between the chores and bottle jar, just me and all the red lights. Keep on driving and driving. In the heat from a hot California. So I'm finishing up going through and sorting all of the toys momentarily, and then I'm going to give you a bit of an overview of what the living room looks like right now and what we're working with. It's a bit of a hot mess, but I have sorted all of the toys into categories that make sense to me so that I can organize and put them away. We tend to choose a specific genre of toys, I think. We like to use natural materials, not anything that's flashy or battery operated, so you'll see a lot of that. And I was super excited because Love Every had gifted us the companion box a few months ago, and wow, am I impressed with the quality and just how engaged my daughter is with the activities. If you're not familiar with Love Every, they make toys specifically designed for learning and supporting brain development. All of their toys are made with sustainable, organic, and natural materials, which I love. And I was so surprised with how much came in one box. All of this stuff was in one box. So I will leave their link below if you're interested in checking them out. And moving on back to my daughter's room. I'm excited to put the finishing touches in here. I'm just moving the furniture around a little bit. And then I'm going to put that teepee that we started with in here. I'm going to make it into like a really sweet, cozy, fun reading nook for her. So I put a blanket down, and then I decided to store all of her stuffed animals in here. She doesn't have a crazy amount, so it worked out, and she absolutely loves it. This is like one of her favorite places to just sit in, and she loves grabbing different animals and having them all out. So it was definitely a win-win. I also grabbed some books and put some books in here so she can read them. She likes to read them to her animals. I originally put that basket there because I thought, okay, if there's too many animals, then she can put some in the basket. But I end up storing blankets there later on. And then over here, I put the baby doll things, but that activity center will go there once we build it and give that to her for her birthday. And next, I'm moving on to the books. So I did have this little bookshelf. Well, I believe it was an entranceway bench, like it had a cushion on top, and I've repurposed it into a bookshelf. And these are books that are not currently in rotation, so it makes more sense to store them in the closet so she's not just pulling them out at random. The bookshelf that was originally in her bedroom, I moved to the living room, so you'll see that later on, and that will have all of her books that are currently out in this rotation. And now comes the fun part, the part that I find the most enjoyable, and that's putting everything away and organizing it all. So I only put a few things in her closet. I didn't want it to be too cluttered. And then I move on to the living room. And that's when I'm gonna basically tackle this table. So I guess I'm really in like the dining room right now. But I'm just going through and organizing all of the things into bins and boxes, whatever I'm gonna use for storage. And then we're gonna be putting it all away. And I'm so excited for you guys to see the final product. I find this kind of stuff super satisfying.
Never up, never down, never. Like a theme in a song, clever. Feeling high, feeling low at the same time. Feel so right, then I'm wrong, hoping I'll be fine. But I get up, I always do. I never think, I always do. Never thought I wouldn't jump, oh what a fool.
The majority of my daughter's toys. I've tried her bedroom closet, I've tried a linen closet, and this just works best for me. So I'm going to finish putting everything away. I love how organized it looks. I will show you a before and after of this area, and then I'm going to show you what I did to the living room. Other thing I'm noticing I don't have the best storage for is arts and crafts stuff. So I did actually put an arts and craft table. It's just a wooden table and it has shelves that you can put all sorts of arts and crafts stuff. And I think there's a thing that you can hook paper to so that they can pull out paper and, you know, just be creative. My parents bought that for my daughter for her birthday, so she'll be getting that as well, and we'll put that in the living room somewhere, so all of her arts and crafts stuff I won't have to put in these bins. I can free up some things and we'll have a whole section that will be dedicated to that, so I'm looking forward to that as well.
I never think, I always do. Never thought I wouldn't jump, oh what a
So I'm going to show you a bit of a before and after so you can see the progress here. And then I'm going to show you the living room before and you can see the pretty dramatic difference. I rearranged the entire thing and I just love how it turned out. So thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed and leave a comment below so we can chat. I'll see you in my next one. Bye.